Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how to add Automator actions as calendar alarms. So before Yosemite, you used to be able to create calendar events that then had Automator tasks or Apple script as the alarm. So for instance, I would be able to go create an event, say test, and I could set an alert and choose custom, and one of the options here would be to have a Automator script run. But you don't no longer have that. And there's a couple reasons for that, but there's also ways to get it back. Mainly the reason is because now we all use iCloud calendars, which are great because they sync across all your devices, including iOS, and it doesn't make sense to have Automator or Apple script events there because on iOS, of course, there is no Automator or Apple script. You want events that will actually occur across your devices. So one way to get an Automator script to run with the calendar on your Mac in Yosemite is to start with Automator. So now when I run Automator, I'm asked to choose the type of document when I create a new document here. And I'm going to choose Calendar Alarm, which is new for Yosemite, and it's in El Capitan as well. And I will choose that, and then I get a blank document here where I'll add something to it. Let's add a simple Apple script, run Apple script, and then I'll just put in a little alert. Great. So now I'll test it. I can see it just displays a little test message there. And now I'll save it. And now it's going to ask to save the alarm. I'll give it a name like test alarm. And what it's going to do here, it's going to then run calendar. And it's going to do a few things. First, it'll run the script there, and I'll see it there. And I'll see it disappear as a notification. It also created a special calendar that's on my Mac. So this is not shared with any other my other devices. It's just on this Mac, and it's called Automator Calendar. And it's put that test alarm, it's put a sample there. Basically, it just set it for right now. And that's why the alarm went off immediately. And this special Automator Calendar here is now where any Automator task I create as a calendar alarm will appear. It'll appear under this. So this is a special calendar just for running these kinds of Automator tasks. So let's take a look at this event here. And you can see it looks like an open file alert at time of event, but it is not. If you try to change that, it doesn't really come up. It comes up there in that menu, and then you hit custom, and it doesn't even show that here. So you don't want to mess with the type of alert or most of the stuff here for these special events. What you can mess with is the timing of them. So for instance, I can change it to a different time, and I can even set it to repeat, say every day. And you can see that it appears every day. It'll go off at that time. So I can mess with that, and then it will work and go off at the same time every day now, and then I can go back in and mess with it again. So timing is what you want to change, but not necessarily what some of those other features are. If you want to change what the alert does, you can go back into Automator here, and I'm still editing this script here, and I can change it, say, so I change what text appears, and I can just Command S for save. So you can do that. Now you can also get to these scripts, by the way, by looking in the Finder. If I look here at the top, I can see I'm going to use the Command and click here at the top, and you can see that it's saving it in my User Library folder under Workflows, Applications, Calendar, and then there's the app that it's saved. So I can get access to these later, even if it just appears from my Recent menu here in Automator. Now there is an alternative, and I hinted at this before. The problem is that you can't have Automator tasks running in iCloud calendars, but you can have them running on all my Mac calendars. So you can create a new on my Mac calendar. If you go to File, New Calendar, you can create one on my Mac. That only appears if you already have an on my Mac calendar. If you only have iCloud calendars, that won't appear, but you usually do have other calendars, and I find that if you control click underneath Other, you can create a new calendar and it will appear as an All My Mac calendar. So if you need to create your first one, that's kind of the trick to do it. So with this calendar here, I can select it and I can create a new event, and under this event I can add an alert that is open file, and I can then choose other for open file. Now I'll go to the desktop, and let's say I want to have an Automator task here. So I'm going to create a new Automator task that is an application, and then I'm going to run AppleScript inside of that. And save it onto the desktop like that. Now when I go back into Calendar, I can see it appear there, and I can actually add it open file and put that app there at the time of event. And now I can play with this in the same way I could do the Automator calendar. Matter of fact, they're kind of the same thing, just that this one will automatically, you can create things in Automator that's a calendar and automatically will put them in here. Whereas for this on my Mac calendar, I'm actually adding them manually. So if you've been looking for a way to add Automator or AppleScript tasks to calendars on your Mac, this is the way to do it in Yosemite and beyond. It actually really hasn't changed much. It's just that now iCloud being the predominant calendar, which doesn't allow those because of the limitations and other security issues and things like that, you just have to note that you have to go with an on my Mac calendar or use Automator's automatic calendar to add these types of alarms.